gonna be like the first left animal shortly. Now he's walking so early.
Right.
Yeah, and I see those two standing broadside.
Is he button heads or a different ones?
No, no, they're two standing broadside.
Uh huh.
There's a bunch walking behind them.
Right.
Oh, those two standing broadside, the right hand one.
Okay. There's one behind him.
There's ones behind
him. I'm gonna
him.
Shoot, okay?
Yeah, when there's a chance, then.
Right
shoot.
Now, cover yours. Shit, I had him. Hold on. Find him again. Okay, I got him. He's turning right. He's okay. I got him.
Okay, so the furthest left.
Yeah,
and
cover yours.
One to the right.
To the right, right. Drop it.
Drop it.
I heard a hit. That was the right one, right?
Excellent, good
yeah.
job.
Yeah, thank you.
It was 585.
Yeah, I put it at 600 yards.
Excellent.
575. Yeah, I heard it. Whap. So
yeah,
down?
I think you hit him high on the shoulder, just hit that spine, he collapsed right there.
Okay, keep an eye and make sure I can get up.
Yeah.
Let me see that. He's heavy.
That is a big order.
Yeah. Look at that, Filippo.
Thank you.
Good job.
Thanks for
very,
everything.
Very good job.
Yeah, he's a dandy. Jeez.
That is a big order.
Yes, he is.
View the mass on that.
Beautiful animal.
Cracking up his boss is heavy. Very long. That is a good
order. Hit him at.
Hit him. Angled in there. Uh-huh. Excellent through the neck.
Yeah,
listen, we did have a bit of wind drift over here. But
a little bit, yeah. Find him right there.
But he's dead.
Yeah. Yep.
He's dead and it's going to be
beautiful. Beautiful. Thank you.
Good job, sir.
One down.
Yeah, one down. Many more to go. Let the fun continue.
Thanks, Jonix. The far reason gun works, I'll tell you, it works.
Yeah, the system really does work.
Yeah.
So you'll find in dry riverbeds like this, and then on the road where you've got like even a small termite mound or a little bit of ground, like a little lump, they'll rub their horns and they knock it around. So you can see the wildebeest tracks coming here. Obviously, working this area where we saw these cows up here, it's just part of his scent marking. So he's been rubbing his horns here. Massive geographical basin here. Wind's always going to swirl. We're going to come right on the left hand side. Up top here, you'll see some long grass blades.
They should be down there.
And yeah, they can go down there. We generally, from experience, hunting, I know if we're on this side, although the wind's swirling, we generally say. I'm just going to climb out here and get some elevation, see if we can spot these things here. Right down there, it runs all the way down to under his brisket there. Just a nice old pool, as you can see.
size, that's mass on that thing.
Big bosses on it.
Bosses all cracked
He's
up.
He's old, isn't he?
Yeah, old bull. Old
nice. Very You're right, they're not that big. They're the bigger one they're standing out there.
Very fun.
Very nice.
Seen the ram, we know where he is, and get ready to shoot.
Okay. Perfect.
Timing just right. The rain's closing in on us again.
Here it comes again. Every time we pull the trigger, it starts raining.
Just this side over here, there's like a dry creek bed. A lot of this like thorn tree thicket up there, they like to sit in there, it's nice and warm for them, and it's cold. You can see the slope up here, they kind of just on top there making their way down. They're trying to, looks to me like the front females want to pull a right and come this down this face, and we'll just watch them from here and see where they go. That old house, instead of using our height advantage, we're gonna cut over here. Yeah. If we have to, we come, there's a lot of blood here, so a good trail for us to follow. But we cut over here and try to see them in the river down there.
We actually got the thing.
Oh yeah, I know.
I mean,
that thing would have never died, you know that? It would have went forever, it looked like.
It's just unbelievable how strong these animals are. I mean, that's where their reputation comes from. You know, we've chased this thing all of yesterday afternoon, overnight, and it's still running strong. Just glad we got the thing.
Boy, these stripes are pretty, aren't they?
Beautiful animal, eh? Check it out, really. We'll show you.
totally different from the other ones.
It's totally different from the black that we got yesterday. Mm-hmm. But check, it's just like the, you know, what we call the poor man's buffalo. It's as tough as a buffalo, but costs a lot less. Mm-hmm. Has that same spread out horns. Nice drop in this one's horns. Just a lovely old bull. Heavy and tough as as anything, as we found
totally
out.
They're totally different than the black. I thought they always were the same animal, pretty much. Yeah, totally different. Well, thank you.
We got him, but we must check your rifle later.
Yeah.
Shooting a little bit high.
Because everything's
most things
high.
Getting a couple inches high.
Look at all the critters we've been killing. Everything's been high,
a little
high.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But he's down quite a steep shot, but we got it. Just over 400. That's what we were talking about the other day. There's always opportunity for something. You're hunting, these mornings. You shoot this and then a herd of kudu come out behind us, some nice bulls and things.
Yeah.
It's just epic.
It is.
It's just epic.
Yeah.
It's a privilege to hunt in places like this.
We drive up a canyon, we see 5-6 different kinds of variety of animals.
Yeah,
you know?
It's awesome. Really awesome.
Like you said, you never know what you're gonna run into.
Trophy prep.
Yes.
Important business. Photos last a lifetime.
We're raiding the kitchen.
Now these scopes here, the short line under the three should be right the 300 line, right? That one?
Yeah.
Just the way they're made, you know what I mean?
He dropped right there.
I couldn't.
Just, it was 707 on the shoot to solution. 707.
Is he still down?
Brilliant. Dropped him right there. He just folded in those trees there. Crikey, it's a far way.
Too cool.
The animal was so confused. That first shot, he's just like running around. I was like, where are these shots coming from? And we kind of.
And they came close too, real close.
Yeah, came running closer. We kind of hidden away here. There's no clue where yet. Awesome. Good job.
Seven, that's his furthest shot so far.
Furthest shot so far, excellent.
It's possible.
It is possible.
Practice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
Really. Calling the wind and calling the distance is the hardest thing.
Yeah.
You gotta have a spotter.
Yeah, for sure.
You can't do it by yourself. Where's the hole?
On the shoulder.
Is it?
Yeah, somewhere. Right there? Perfect. Right there. High shoulder, dropped him right there.
That's
good
pretty,
job.
Thank you. Got these pieces of work, aren't they?
Oh, beautiful animals.
Beautiful, beautiful coloring on them.
Very cool, eh? I'm very happy.
Yes, from way over there somewhere.
Yeah, across this ditch down there into the bottom plane. Excellent.
That's why you couldn't see us from the top.
Yeah, from his angle you can see now our truck was actually behind those trees, so we were lying kind of in the shadow there, so it worked out perfectly. But man, you hit him so perfectly.
The bush there, you know, and it was coming, then the hail came down and he goes,
"Remember, these things are so quiet. I was
I think we should go
to the
buffalo." I'm right with you.
I'll follow you. Lead the way. Yeah.
What's on the Bible? Hey,
get a legend.
Yeah.
Good job!
Did he go down?
Yeah. Dropped him right there.
Thanks.
Good job, jeez. Hit him perfect, just the classic high shoulder shot. Yeah, just cool. Folded him right there.
I heard it, but I couldn't see. I lost it with my shot. Yeah.
Awesome.
Thank you again. Yes.
Good job.
Yeah. This hair here is very long, and when they're kind of displaying, or they're pronking around, or they want to like ward off predators, they try and make themselves look bigger. So they fan this out. It fans out to about there, like that. So all this long hair fans out right to its tail. And they've got a scent gland in there, which you can see. Mm-hmm. It's got a very sweet, like sugary smell to it.
Yeah, they say like a vanilla smell or something.
Yeah. So now in normal, like when you see them trotting around, it's closed up. But if they want to pronk or show dominance or fight other rams, or if they see a predator, they'll open this right out. It's long. See how long
they
hair.
I know, they die, they show it straight up in the air like that. It's a big old thing sticking up.
Yeah. And they fan that whole fan open and pronk.
That's something.
It was perfect shot, it was quartering towards us, you hit him perfectly through those shoulders there.
What a beautiful.
Just a beautiful animal, beautiful. Eh? Nice old ram, you see how he's
heavy.
Worn those ridges?
He's heavy, heavy.
Yeah. Good job.
Thank you guys, very nice.
Head quite in the picture. Yeah, they're perfect.
About right there?
Okay. Yeah, I'll get everything in the picture.
There.
Just see the top herd, and they're like 1,000 yards out, but we're going perfectly like this. We're going to just keep on the edge of this rim of this ledge here, just keep going around and go up that draw. I think we're getting nice and close. Just keep going like this, it's good for us. Carry on up this creek. Remember from across the canyon, that's how we saw those quite big thickets. I mean, the thickets suddenly stopped, and then they weren't a couple hundred yards from there. So, you know, best case scenario, we can stay right in the creek the whole way till the edge of that thicket and, you know, shoot off a tree or something, you know. But we'll have a look now. We'll see when we start climbing if we can spot them there. They are kind of just out this creek. Lying down. It's a bachelor herd, of course, low down. That herd is high up on the ridge. They're lying probably under 300 yards from us. We're already where we are. But at this angle,
yeah, there's some big trees in the way. We won't be able to get a shot. I want to walk just to that big tree over there. And we might, I just got to see how high, if we can get some height there. But the problem is they're going to be too close going up this creek. Right there, they're like 50 yards out of the creek. So they'll be too close for us, actually. So we're just going to go here and try to find the highest spot.
Broadside, he's in the gap in the middle.
Yeah.
That's him.
That's him.
Take him low on the shoulder. He's within 200. Good shot. Oh, he's done. He's done for. The shot looked so good at first, you know, that's why. But we lost sight of them as I went behind the trees here. But I counted 8 bulls initially.
There's 7 there now.
There are 7 there now. That's why. And when I looked there now, I looked carefully at the spotting scope and I couldn't see anything on any of those animals. There's only one other that had a similar horn shape. Okay, he's lying. He curled up 30 yards from where we hit him originally. Good job, man. Good job.
Well,
there he is.
Low too, doesn't
he? Check it out. That right there, it's a big black wildebeest. Check how wide this thing is. Yeah, his horns just sweep forward and out. Drops well below his eyes. I mean, check out the mass on this thing. My goodness. I mean, he got more than 10 inches across there. It's unbelievable.
Thank you.
Brilliant. Thank you. Great shot. I mean, it's perfect, hard shot. That's why I went barely 30 yards and piled up. Fantastic. Yeah. If you don't hit them right, these things go. But man, this is textbook. Textbook. Broadside now.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's looking back to his right. Yeah, kind of back towards us. There's one trotting above him.
Oh, how far was he? I had like 6.
So, in case you didn't realize, we thought it was a miss.
How many luck?
Tracker says he had good luck. We were lined up, very confusing, a lot of different animals walking, changing positions, and then had a shot. Shot sounded good, but we saw nothing. We're kind of like focusing. The one tracker calls me and says, oh, where must he come collect the animals? What are you talking about? He said, no, he saw one drop right there. And the other tracker said, no, he's not sure. He didn't see one drop. And so I said, Trey, well, let's go look there. And we reviewed the footage now quickly on the camera, and you can see clear as day, perfect shot. That 600.
I was looking at the wrong one. You guys were looking at
615. Luckily, it wasn't a female, so he shot a nice ram.
I can see the horn on him walking, messing around. Like I said, on it.
So it worked out good, but yeah, we were stressing.
And he said
out.
It's a good one?
Yeah, it's a good size one. And we shot it that on the rangefinder check now. 615.
Good.
Brilliant. Well done.
Well, thank you. Thanks, Rudy, for seeing that.
Yeah.
Thank you. For seeing.
This is a good one. This is a nice heavy old ram.
Oh really?
It's heavy, really nice old ram.
Cool.
He
is heavy.
I can't believe it just dropped right there.
Very heavy.
See, you were so far ahead of, oh, like you say, our field of view, like zoom into the scope and that.
I only had a few I can see, you know?
Yeah.
I didn't have to get up once looking at the binoculars because I couldn't tell, they're running too much.
Yeah, exactly.
So it turned out perfect, beautiful animal.
Yeah, all beautiful, right? We'll be right back.
over the step is where we saw that big herd of cows. There's a very deep valley here, you can't see from anywhere else. We go over here and find a position where we can just cross for a long dive, and eventually you'll see something in this valley in front of us.
Like a nice bull.
Good job. Fingers.
The dark black face.
Mm-hmm. See, that's exactly like the rat there walking around following the cows.
He never saw it. She did. He never knew we were there.
Stupidly came out.
Uh-huh. I can see him through the trees, but I thought it was a cow and a calf.
Old bull, you see that? Down to the gums.
Yes, good. That's the best one to take out, isn't it?
Exactly. See the rut being that hard on him, he's losing condition, looking a bit skinny and everything.
Beautiful.
Look at that.
Tight curls, nice.
Yeah. See, what we're looking for is the thing with just the we've seen a lot of bulls where the points kind of end here, right, or they're pointing straight back.
Right.
You need just but to come around, exactly. Come back,
with get this a bit right
of
here.
An inch and a half ivory over there, coming back.
He
nice
really stood
bull
out when he came around that corner, not like the other ones.
See, he's been fighting lots, so he's torn his ear, and that's quite fresh. It's
pretty fresh.
In the rut, he's torn his ear. Mm-hmm. But beautiful. And check the front here is what we saw from the other bull. It's just this long mane that hangs here. Mm-hmm. Good job, Freddie.
Oh, thank you very much. Sir. Good job. Good hike.
Yeah. Cool is that, eh?
Where'd the bullet hit him at?
The bullet perfectly through the shoulders, blew the shoulder out here in the back. Right. Hit him right here. He has the entry hole right here. So you see this dyke, how much grey hair he's got?
Uh-huh.
Oh my goodness, check, he's broken.
Missing our teeth.
Broken teeth out. But check here between shoulder blades, all the grey hair in there. It's quite unusual. But yeah, tiny, tiny.
Very cool little animal, eh?
Thank you. That's probably the best one of the trip so far.
You see how small this thing, this is why I was getting so excited. We shot it from the top of the hill there. I mean, that your kill zone is, I mean, his whole chest cavity is 8 inches high, not even. It's less than that. It's, you know, your kill zone, like I said, is just an area the size of my hand. So,
what a beautiful, beautiful little animal.
It's a freaking good shot at that distance. Came running from the top and just face planted. How awesome is that?
Unbelievable.
My goodness.
He's tall, isn't he?
Tall. Yeah. He's just the all-round package.
I mean,
this guy's got like 2.5 inches of white ivory tips, perfectly symmetrical. Just a heck of a bull.
Wow. Funny that first shot already clipped his back.
Yeah.
Surprised he was so calm.
Well done.
Well, thank you again. like
now this. The plan to get him out of here is the next part of the deal.
In pieces?
Pieces. Yeah, us few guys are going to have to pieces. There's no option to take it out whole.
Yes, this is the part of the first experience.
Carry your own trophy off. Up and away with it, sir.
Can I just stay up there?
Stay up the trail, you come right.
Okay, now
me top.
Just stay at the truck with you guys?
Yeah.
You guys want me to bring you back a water or something?
No, no, stay there. Okay. Or you can come back in case we leave something behind.
Yeah, no problem.
Head up there,
I'll be right back.
Go with it.
Getting ready? Okay.
Okay. Dropped him.
Ooh! Nice. I saw him fall through the scope. Thank you.
Good job. We were up high on the canyon, came glassing down in the thick ravine here, and this is my very good buddy's ranch this side. And I saw pigs coming through the fence, just feeding. So we came all the way down and lined up here and managed to get a really nice hog feeding in the middle of the open grass plain there. So very happy about that.
Very good.
Last day, last animal of the safari. And
our last animal of the trip.
We've done good.
Number 13.
Good. He's a good hog, this. This is a huge hog.
I can see the tusks of the scope.
That.
Is a toad.
Proper hog.
Thank you.
Again. Pleasure, sir.
Way to finish the safari, my goodness.
Yeah, perfect way to end.
Yep.
And a perfect hunt. Fantastic. Very, very happy with that hog.
Look at this. Oh.